In this video, we'll be going over a few best practices to keep in mind when designing holographic stickers in Adobe Illustrator. Here is the design we're looking to have printed as a holographic sticker. We could upload this as is, and Sticker Mule will automatically format the design for holographic stickers, but there are a few easy changes we can make that will really help our final sticker shine. So before printing, let's perform those together. While the holographic material these stickers are printed on will mix with whatever colors you have in your design, leaving empty spaces is a great way to show off the material on its own. Consider the head of our robot, which was colored gray to make it look like metal. Sure, we could leave it this way, and the holographic material would mix in with the gray and give us a metallic look. However, the holographic material stands out the most when it's not mixed with color. And since this is a robot, making his head as silvery and reflective as possible could be our best approach in getting across this idea of metal. So how do we show just the holographic material? Simple. Any part of your design that is empty will do this. We'll just select the gray shape and remove the fill. Now, when we receive our proof before printing, we will see that the holographic effect is applied fully to the robot's head. While empty space in your design will show off the entire holographic material, colors will mix with it, but not all colors combine the same. Lighter colors blend more with the holographic material, creating a silvery tint to the color when printed. Darker colors blend less with the material, still showing the holographic effect, but printing closer to your design. In our current design, a pinky red has been used for the robot's cheeks. Because this color is fairly light, it will blend in a lot with the holographic material. Since we've decided the head will be completely holographic, it would be nice to contrast that with a darker, more solid red rather than the current light one. So let's do that now. Overall, if your colors work well together in your design, they will continue to when printed as a holographic sticker. So you don't need to worry too much about this. That being said, it's good to remember that darker colors stand out more than lighter ones, so adjust appropriately. While most colors blend with the holographic material, there are two that almost entirely cover it up. That's black and white. Because of this, black and white are great ways to add contrast to your design and break up the holographic effect. If the entire sticker has the effect applied to it, any areas that don't are really going to stand out. All of the line work in our design is black, so we can already be confident that it will contrast well with the holographic effect. But are there any areas where we should use white? Remember that any area left empty will reveal untouched holographic material. So in addition to the head, that currently includes the eyes and teeth. But those are excellent spots to add white. All we need to do to indicate the use of white is create a shape with a white fill. This can be confusing since a white fill and no fill look the same on the default white background inside of Illustrator. Because of that, we recommend two things. First, we recommend creating a colored background on a separate layer. This will make it a lot easier to see what we're doing. Second, it's helpful to create a layer called white ink to keep all of our white shapes on. With the eyes and teeth of our design selected, we can fill it with white and move it to our white ink layer. One final step we're going to do is add a white ink border. A holographic border will be added by default, and it looks great, but you might decide that sometimes a traditional white border is preferable. To do that, we're going to create a white fill that's the entire size of our design. Then we're going to offset it by how much we want our border to be. We'll use 20 pixels. Let's add a stroke to this shape to indicate where we want our sticker to be cut. We'll put this shape on a layer called cut line. Then we'll offset this shape a bit more just so that there's some bleed outside of our crop marks. And this shape we're going to fill with white and put it on our white ink layer. Here's a good example of why the colored background is helpful. We accidentally made the inside of the head white instead of empty, but we can quickly fix that. Again, Using a background while doing these steps will make it a lot easier to see what you're doing. When you're done, just delete that layer. By keeping these best practices in mind, you'll be able to optimize your designs for printing holographic stickers. When in doubt, you can always submit your design however it is to Sticker Mule and receive a proof of what it will look like. If something doesn't seem right, just request a change and we'll be happy to make it for you. If you found this video useful, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and click the bell to stay up to date on future videos. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching.